Hello, welcome everybody. I'm just waiting for a few more people to join before we start the haircut for you. I just want to say a huge thank you for giving up your time to watch this live. I'm really excited to be doing it. It's just very nice to be able to do something, to share what I have been practicing, what I've learned with you all. So thank you for the opportunity. I'm very excited to be here today. What I'm going to be doing for you is a cutting demonstration. I'm going to be working on combining two different core shapes. I'm going to be combining round initially, and I'm going to be combining that into triangle. So this side of the haircut has been mapped for me to do a triangular graduation, whilst this side has been mapped for me to do a more round graduation. We're going to be combining them seamlessly with no disconnection. What I'm going to do firstly is start my haircut on the round side. This is because I start the round side at the front and I work towards the back. And I start the triangular shape from the back and work forward. So it makes sense to start the round side first. So if you're looking at doing something where you're going to be combining core shapes, they all have principles that we can work to, and that is generally how we decide on what we're going to do. Hello to everybody. So to start a round graduation, we are simply going to start. Let's just see if I can't pan this round a bit more. We're going to start the haircut with a very slight diagonal back section. This allows me to start cutting the length front. The reason we take it close to the vertical is that it allows me to take all the section across the hairline. This helps me how? This helps me because if I just ran my section diagonal back close to the horizontal and work back, there's a risk that this section here could be cut too short. And as it falls, it could fall higher than the base. We don't want that. Let's get in a little bit closer. So thanks for your patience, guys. I'm just trying to make this as useful as possible for you today. So as we turn this round, and I wanted to say a big thank you to Sebastian. Thank you, Sebastian, because you made this possible. So thank you. So don't apply the tension with your hand. When I let the tension go, the hair will spring. So I initially hold the hair in place to set the distribution or the cut line. What I then do is use the tension in the comb to make this consistent. So as I pull down, I keep the tension in the comb, I get equal tension, and I'm going to, my cut line will be going very slightly diagonal back. So your cut line will be going slightly lower towards the base. So as I go down here, as I go down, my cut line is going round, okay? So we're gonna be starting to aim our section here towards the lips. I may take that a little bit shorter, just a little bit shorter. I hope everybody is staying safe in Poland and worldwide in this very strange time. Now, my second section is starting from this side again. And it is going to be another diagonal back, but this time the diagonal is moving slightly closer to the horizontal. So let's groom this hair out of the way. Sebastian might recognize these clips from our good friend JB Mazzella. So as I groom this hair all down, as I come down, I'm going to be taking this section further into the back. So it's creating my curved line. Okay. But Jinquia. So as we come back here, our section will come all the way back into the back. So this is our third section. Our third section is allowing us to come much closer to the back of the section. This will help us to set the length around the nape of the neck. Just get that a little bit neater. So now as we take the section, our section is running from the front into the back. We don't want to take too much hair at once. As I come through here, our elevation is currently working on a finger's depth elevation. This is giving us a much more strength on our line. The higher the elevation, the less strength our line will have. Now, as I come through here, my diagonal back section is now going into the neck here. A big mistake I used to always make was having the angle getting lower and lower and lower. This would almost give me a mullet effect at the back. And now I pull the section, but I work square to the head. I lift this section here and I work square to the head. So I'm cutting my line parallel to the head, in essence round. So that means our line is round, shorter to longer, and our horizontal shape will be round. Now, our next section will remain parallel to the same section we just cut. I'm trying to read the comments. I'm just going to put another light on, see if this helps. Is that better? Yes. So I come round here, I'm lifting the previous section up. So if we go too low, too long, too heavy. And as you can see, our section begins to be more equal as we're working round. So when we work round, it means we're following the shape of the head. Our section's equal in its length. Our next section. So you see, the hair's getting smaller and smaller. So the hair here, where the hairline is at its thinnest, is the heaviest part of our line. As we work back, the elevation is lifted. This is important, as we don't want the elevation to be too heavy, the weight, excuse me, to be too heavy. Now we're starting to lift the section. I'm just using my new scissors. They're a 4.5-inch Mizutani retro scissor. A little gift to myself for my 40th birthday. As I lift the section, I have equal tension. I focus very much on where the root is coming from. Move the head so my body is always square. So what I mean is, my body, if it is square to the head, I'm in more control of my movements going from the side to the side. Right now, we don't want any over direction. Our elevation is controlling how much length we're building vertically and how much weight we're building vertically. The over direction we don't need at the moment. If we are not working square to the head, hey Michael, how's it going? If we're not working square to the head, we're not assessing fully our over direction. So if I was stood here, which is away from the section, and pull this, I almost want to pull it towards me, which means I'm over directing it. If I'm stood square to my section like so, and I pull it out and over, I can see exactly the movements from the side to the side. As I'm filming alone, I'm trying to keep an eye on any questions. Sadly, I don't speak Polish, sadly. I can only say dziękuję, I think that means thank you. And proszę, I think that means please. But that is all I can speak, sadly. Maybe I should be learning another language whilst we're all in lockdown in the United Kingdom. So you see my sections are moving. We're going through. You can see my line below. You can see as the guideline, the line is curved. Hey, UK, how was it going, guys? My line is curved. Okay. Equal moisture is really important. The equal moisture helps us to maintain the equal tension, which of course is about equal shape. Can everyone see? See if I can make this a little bit better for you guys to see. I think that's better. So as we come down here, we would use the elevation, which is the control up and down, to lift, to create our distribution, which is the choice of line we're going to cut, softer than when it sits down lower. So it's going to be traveling longer. I move the head to maintain my square body position. I work through and I'm elevating the section the same. I'm only cutting to my second knuckle. If I cut past this knuckle, the tension is different. In here, the tension's looser than here. Here, I can't get the cone through. Here, I can. So the tensions are different. Lifting the section, you'll notice I'm combing the previous section up. This is to help me control the amount of weight I'm going to have in my haircut. So as I retake that, I was checking out the shop a moment ago on this Facebook page. You should definitely look at some of the merchandise these guys have got. Sebastian has made an amazing company here along with his friends. And it's unbelievable. There's things they're selling. I'm definitely making a purchase of the. There's a great ruler they sell with the hair. I just realized I look like an angel there with the light on me. So I will check out their shop in a moment. I know I will be after this live. As we go through, my sections are not changing, they're not pivoting. I'm also very jealous of Sebastian's mustache. I can't grow a proper mustache, so I was very jealous to see that. At 40 years old, I still can't grow a proper mustache. That's very disappointing. So by lifting the section, we're creating a softer finish to the outline, and we are making sure the weight is not stationary, but it is true. We refer to true as one of the two different forms of graduation. True graduation is a slow and steady buildup of length and weight. Stationary graduation is more of an immediate buildup of length and weight. So I hope this is helping. Hope this is helping everybody who's in lockdown as well. As I go through my sections, all mirroring the same. If the elevation is too low, what would happen? We'd start to form a line. A line would be quite visible on your haircut. We don't want that. We don't want a step of weight. We want a soft and consistent buildup of weight. This is really why my elevation is the way it is. I'm lifting the hair. I'm lifting what I've just cut as my guide up, then finishing by grooming the hair down. One of the mistakes I've made many, many times in this with this haircut was going too low and then relying on texturizing the hair. Does that say? Okay. And then relying on texturizing the weight out at the end, which obviously we don't want to do. We want to be getting the technique right to this haircut. You see my sections? If I was doing the other side, the same as this, my section would be crossing over, but I'm not currently doing that. Remember what I said? I'm going to be disconnecting my round shape that I'm building here into a, I'm going to be blending a round into triangular. Just a very simple, classic haircut that I practice classic Sassoon haircuts all the time. Let's move this back a little. I reverse the grip of my scissor to enable less stress running across the tendons in my thumb and the joints in my wrist. So sometimes if I'm doing this, there's no pressure here. I'm keeping this straight. If I do that, I suddenly lose all this, the control in here and start applying a lot of pressure to my hair. So as I come down again, I'm just going to remove some of the previous sections so that my guideline isn't going to be taken from too low of a position. So I'm trying to work with really no more than just two sections at once. So if I wear this back, you start to create, the weight is traveling towards the occipital bone. If I wear it forward, it's flattening it at the front. So very simple, very simple. Sometimes if I was doing a client and the client had fairly curly hair, I maybe wouldn't keep wetting the hair down. I'd maybe want to see the haircut developing. But yes, Sebastian had one of my dear friends and mentors doing a live of the day for you. He had Jean-Baptiste Mazzella, who is a dear friend and a mentor to myself. Very, very amazing hairdresser. Focus on the roots to the tip. Focus on the movement from the roots. Because no matter what you're doing here, if the roots are not correct, it won't matter. The roots are not traveling where you want them to be, it won't matter at all. Okay, so now, I always say there's no real point in cross-checking like this because you should have it neat because you've been doing it in that way. I would maybe go through and just cross-check slightly off the vertical. So as I go through, maybe a little bit just there. So you just see me cross-check. So because we've been working this way, I cross-check more vertical. So this side is now done. I'm now going to just put my section into the haircut, ready to start this side. I'm going to do the top of this side when I do the top of this side. Okay. So, triangular graduation. The first thing we will do here is to retake section one from here, okay. And we're just gonna groom this hair away and just say goodbye to it for a moment. What I'm now gonna do is create my guideline utilizing the vertical shape from my haircut. So here, we're going to be cutting a vertically triangular shape. This is going to position the weight right here. One of the reasons we would start vertical with a graduated bob is whatever length we cut this, this is where the weight will sit. This is where you'll start to build your weight. So I'm not going to take this all in one because it's too much hair. And you can see by cutting like this, the length here is greater than the length there. I'm just using a pair of 4.5-inch scissors today. I made a joke by thinking it'd probably take me 4 hours to do a scissor over comb with these, but they are beautiful scissors. Now, the next step is we are going to create ourselves a guideline horizontally. So you now have your vertical guideline, but we're now going to create your horizontal guideline. Now, this is because when you pivot like this to work parallel to our four diagonal section, how do you know the angle of your triangle? You're not a protractor, you could do many different versions or very different angles. So to really help you keep this aligned, we're going to create ourselves a guideline working horizontal as well. Now, to do this, I will very, very simply take my first section from my vertical and I'm going to work square to the head, flat to the head. Not necessarily flat this way. If I do it this way sometimes, I get too much length at the front. So I'm just going to come square off that section. If I can see, maybe make this a bit more square to what I'm doing. Like this. So square here, not square here. Okay. Now, just going to remist all the hair. Now I'm going to go from here straight down. So here I'm not over directing this back. It's almost going to travel back to the wall behind me and connect vertically and horizontally. So if I just slightly pull this over, as I pull the section, I groom the previous section up and you see my guideline. Can you everybody see that? Good. So you can see as my vertical shape drops, the weight is sitting here. As we go through the next section, when I teach this haircut, I find I talk a lot more about this particular part of the haircut than any other. So if you do this haircut, I suppose this is the area where there's the most work to do initially. Once again, I'm using my guideline from the horizontal. Keep checking it. Sometimes I've noticed in the past I may have to go over what I've done a couple of times. So I just like to keep checking my work as I go. So here I go in, remove some of the previous and just take two sections. elevate the section fairly high. I was surprised actually how high I was elevating this when I was retraining myself on this haircut. I think I always worked very low with the elevation, which always gave me more of a stationary graduation, of course. And I'm not going to take that all in one. I'm going to split that into two sections, get that a little bit neater. Everybody happy? Everybody enjoying it? So, just slightly lower. At this point in time, we are not focusing on our line. We are just building the graduation at the moment. The line will come once I've wrap dried my work at the end. I will introduce the line then. So I won't be doing the line until the hair is dry. If you wanted the front to be longer, you could pull this back more. But I think you can see the shape is fairly obvious. See if I can just move this writing down a bit out of the way. I don't know if I can. But yeah, you can really see the shape is coming through. So let's have a little cross check. So as I cross check, can everybody see? Okay, good, good, happy. I don't mean to sound surprised, but it's always nice when it works for us. I was pretty busy before the coronavirus outbreak. So like most educators, I was very sad that everybody in our industry was having to go through hard times. So once again, I want to thank Sebastian and his team for having me here to share my work with you. So thank you. So forward diagonal. Okay. Just remove that out of the way for now. So my next section is utilizing the previous section and lifting it, and there is the guideline. You can see through there. So I'm cutting now. You can make this heavier, you can make this look more transient and more layered. Very, very simply, with the movement of the hair up and down, the elevation. The higher I go, the less weight I form. The lower I go, the heavier it's going to be. Okay. I may just have a little cross check again just to make sure that's fine. And you see that's working fine. Just I would advise you to keep cross checking your work as much as possible. I'll take my next section. If you make the size of your sections inconsistent, this can have a negative effect on your end result. So just make sure that you are taking consistently sized sections. So I want to show you from this elevation how I move the hair up and down. I take a very small section from underneath. If you take too much hair underneath, you don't know exactly where to lift it. There'll be many different guides. If you have three or four hair sections in here, which section are you bringing it to? Section 2, 3, 4, which one? So take a very, very small section. Now, we're going to take out, if we took our elevation really low like this, we'd maybe create a line or step within the haircut. The higher we lift it, hey Sarah, the much softer the weight line's gonna be. So if you're lifting this weight line, That is the control you have of how much weight you're going to have. I often go to the section below and just start to create my guide based on what I've already cut. And as that falls, you can start to see it's traveling forward. That's what we want to happen. I'm working with no over direction here. A lot of graduated haircuts are pulled back at this point. I've been taught different ways of doing this. This could be pulled back here. What I find is that if I'm doing that, my length at the front is quite long. I want the front to be at the similar length of the jawline at the moment. So now, as I take my section, it's going to run much bigger. That's intentional. Don't be alarmed if that's happening. As we take the section, I'm just going to move this hair out of the way. Now we get to cut the length at the front. But remember, right now, we are only focusing on our graduation. We're not focusing on the line. So don't necessarily try to cut this to the perfect length just now. We want a perfect balance in our symmetry with our graduation. The line will come once the hair is dry. So, as I remove some of the previous hair, as I groom the hair up, I'm ensuring my guidelines tension is equal. Now I ensure that my cutting section is equal from root to tip, and I can now begin to cut my section. As I groom it down, it starts to add to the weight and starts to push the weight slightly forward. Now, I take this section from here, leaving the front alone just for the moment. And not take, remember what I said about the guideline? Don't make your guideline too big. Because then you don't know exactly which guide you're going to cut to. So you can start to see that forming, guys. So, I remember what I said, I'm not focusing on my line. The line I'm going to cut in later when the hair's dry. Right now, I'm lifting the elevation consistently to the section I've just cut and ensuring that we build the graduation consistently horizontally. This means I don't want there to be like a set of spaniel's ears at the front of this graduated bob. Okay. Simon, I totally agree. You can keep the front longer. Definitely by keeping the horizontal shape square opposed to round as I have been doing, you would have a more elongated shape at the front. But because I've done the other side round, I almost want them to look balanced. So I'm working slightly shorter with my graduation. But it's a good point you make, sir. Consistent sections. Let's do this. So I don't take too much hair. I pull the section down. I groom the section underneath to get consistent tension in my guide. Then consistent tension and consistent elevation as I knit the guide to the cutting section. As I bring it down. Sometimes people want to just learn a haircut. But I would say you need to learn the mechanics of hair cutting and be in control of, I say there are four different movements you're in control of. There's elevation, which is the up and down. There is distribution, which is the shape I choose to cut my cut line. We have over direction and we have tension, okay. So, and then the fifth thing is your position of your body, where you're stood. And I think that if you really work on technique, like Sarah, who was just watching a moment ago, is amazing at what she does. And if you look at some of the hair she produces, you can just tell that Sarah has amazing technique. And that really comes from practice. I must have practiced this haircut 3 times a week for a year, a few years ago. Then I started practicing round graduation. Then it was square. And I just started practicing fundamental haircuts because they were logical and they were not subjective. If someone shows me something that is orientated through trend or being innovative, I may not always understand. Chicago, how's it going, man? I may not understand fully where that came from. You can't train creativity. You can't train someone to be charismatic. You can't teach somebody to dress trendy. You know, so I don't believe we can really teach creativity. We can inspire people, but if you're not careful, they'll just copy your inspiration. But if they understand fully the why and the how of hair up, or if they're wig making or colouring or whatever it is, then they're free to be more innovative and they're free to go on that journey of discovery. And I'm not a creative person. I'm a very pragmatic person. So I like to know A plus B equals C. So with what I do, I focus on teaching people the fundamental why and how of haircutting. And I want you to be in control of the way that you cut hair and go on your own journey of it. Otherwise, I'm just gonna let you copy my work. And that's fine. But you wanna be able to know why you do what you do and how you can change it, dependent on the client, dependent on the hair texture. And the only way to do that is to know your fundamentals and to practice and build your technique. That's the only way you know how to do it, in my opinion. If you look at Sebastian, how amazing he is at cutting hair. Sebastian, I guarantee you now, loves what he does. And he will practice it. He will see it as a lifestyle, not a job. Now, all the great hairdressers that inspire me, John Baptiste Mazzella, Gianni Scamacci, you see that in the way they work, you know. And I just think that there's so much about practice and about developing technique. So you see our shapes coming through now nicely, guys. I'm on my final section before I go back. You know, it's one thing I keep doing, guys, is being I keep spraying the hair. So I'm going to go through and I'm going to just keep going through and just checking the last section. See how that moves? Square, then it was square to the head. I'm not utilizing any over direction because rightfully so, I think someone said earlier that if you over directed this, it could be longer. And I think that's exactly what you can do. But you know, once you really understand how to do the haircut in the strongest possible way, then you're free to look to change it. But I think you should learn the strongest way these haircuts are done first before you do that. Right. Here we go, guys. We can let these clips go. I can groom my round side down. You see the difference now, yeah? Just get this. Because the sections have dried slightly, I'm just going to resection my partings. I chose to do the round side as it was going to be shorter on a side parting. I thought that would look slightly more fitting. So now I'm just going to spray that down. And how do we start this? What do we do? Well, I would start it on a diagonal back section. Why? Why am I going to start this on a diagonal back section? If I'm just lifting this, remember, the elevation wasn't like that. The elevation was low here. That means there's a risk that this section is cut shorter than my line. So let's just see if I can get this really, really on it for you all. So as I take this section, I'm going to work now to slightly curve this forward. Don't bring this down this way because it'll be too short. It's got to come back over. So as I come down here, I watch my tension. I come down and I remove half of that. I found the section was too big. And then I take this section from here and I bring this, and you see now I have the option to slightly curve here. Why do I do that? I find that by bringing that slightly down, it helps when the haircut jumps slightly here. I also think it looks more flattering if it has a slight curve at the front. Okay. So, the next section, it's cut the same. Remember how we did this at the start? Those of you who saw this from the start, it's exactly the same way I started it. Bring the section down. I need to control the length front. Slightly as I cut my scissors come back. Beautiful. Easy, easy. Now, the section can go all the way across the top. Now we're going to start lifting it. Remember the elevation at the front? You can see that shape. You can see it working. Very exciting. My elevation is lower here. Lower here. Because that's my line. Then I start to lift the elevation to match what we did before. This is so we don't suddenly get an irregular line or step in our haircut. So as we work through, I lift the section high and I cut the previous section I did. I take my next section. I'm going to keep it at this angle. Low here, you see? High through here. Why was it low? Because the hairline is the thinnest part of this section and we don't want to create a hole in our line or our haircut. We want consistency. My final section, you can see now my final section, I have my line in place, so this will all be lifted. So I lift this line, groom the hair underneath. I watch where all the roots are going. Every haircut starts from the root. Don't take too much hair, because we don't know exactly where to lift it up or down. Focus on the roots. So that is the round side complete. Now we can do our triangular side. It's very similar. The only difference is we're going to start from the front, the back. The back's going to have the higher elevation, the front's going to have the lower. So in that circumstance, that's the same. The only difference is I'm going to start cutting at the back, so my cut line is longer at the front. As I start here, I cut in exactly the same way I was a moment ago. The way I was explaining about the elevation is all the same. The only difference is you're going to notice something now. What's changing now? Which one of my mechanics is changing right now? That's correct. My elevation, my up and down is changing to compensate for the irregular hairline, the recession in the hairline, to ensure that my length does not have a hole here. Sorry about my little dog. She barks at anything, bless her. So as I bring the section round, let's go to the back and show you that. So again, we take some hair, not loads, not masses. We want our sections being neat and balanced. We lift the haircut up. Now this is vital that was the same length because now it balances. I Well, thank you all for all your positive comments. So maybe lower this a little. So you see here, that the roots are not traveling where I want them. So we have to focus on the roots, get them to move in the direction I want. Remember, the elevation is getting lower towards the very, very front. So let's turn this around slightly. And there is my guideline. As it swings forward, there we go. Lift this a little higher, I think you can all see. Thank you, Sylvia. Thank you, Daniel. You can start to see the shape really coming through there now, guys. You can start to see my weights higher here, coming forward towards the front. As we come through here, my sections remain the same. All my subsequent sections are the same size. They're all taken in the same direction. They just work higher towards the parting. So as I work through here, I don't want to take too much of a guide once again. My body position is consistent. I'm still working square. That's why I keep moving the head. So again, my elevation is only lowering to compensate for how the zones of the hair are getting thinner as we get towards the front. If I remain consistent, the crown is thicker than the apex and the apex is thicker than the front. So that means that we would have an irregular line or irregular build of graduation. What that means is it would look thinner at the front than it did at the back. And that isn't what we want. So as we get towards our final section, see our round shape is heading towards the lips and this shape is heading towards the jaw. So I'm going to start my wrap drying process shortly. So remember, we are not focusing on cutting our line at present. We are only focusing on the graduation. So there we have it. We have our one side as a triangular graduation and our other side as a round graduation. So what I'm just going to focus on now is I'm going to apply a small amount of a leave-in conditioner. And a small amount of cream to help keep the moisture levels and to stop the hair from going fluffy.
Thank you.
Okay, everybody, thanks for being patient. I'm just going to be gliding through a little pair of GHDs now, just to smooth out the edges slightly. So I'm just going to go through very, very quickly, guys, so I can get back to some putting. I'm not holding the straighteners on very long and slightly moving the straightener in to create a slight bend as well. So we don't want to flatten the hair. We really have done a lot of work in the rack dry to get the roots where we want them. We just need the ends to have a slight polish, which is what I feel the straighteners do. They give the hair a lovely polish to the hair. Okay. You can kind of see actually, if you can kind of see that shape just sitting quite nice at the moment. We are starting to get there, so, oops, there he is. I personally use the straightening irons on practically every demonstration I do. I use them, I think they're a great tool. They just add that little bit more smoothness that sometimes I don't always get with my wrap drying or my vest brush. Just really slightly on the ends like this, that gives it a very, very slight, makes it a little bit easier to, when I refine, when I go through and put my outline in, it makes it a little easier on the ends. The ends are a bit straighter for me. If I'd had more time, maybe I would have used a round brush, like a round bristle wire part brush, but that would have taken me a lot longer to done the blow dry. And I'm quite conscious that everybody is just watching me blow dry hair, so I wanted to just make that part as quick as possible. I find that when I do run the irons over the hair, I can almost check my work over too. I'm sure Sebastian is the same, that when he's wrap drying or when he is just finishing off his work, he can almost get an idea of the balance of his work, as I am right now with my haircut. I can see that I'm quite happy with my line work at the moment, even though we weren't focusing on the line. I feel we have got some good balance with that. So when I go over to my round side, again, I work just to flatten the ends and to polish the hair a little. Sometimes I spend a very long time drying the hair, so I've had to be a bit faster today. I just think it can be quite a boring thing to watch, but what's quite exciting is that I'll be doing all my refining in a moment, and that is a really fun part to demonstrate. So as I'm working through here, I can check my work over. You can start to see that my round line is pushing into the lip area. And see it would create a slight bend into the lips. Yeah, I think it's a very difficult time at the minute. In the United Kingdom, we're not sure what's happening at the moment. We find out on Thursday, but I think most people are probably quite similar to me, where we're a little bit tired of not knowing anything. I think that's the biggest thing, really. It's just, we're all not earning any money. So
you know, everything we do, every doll's head, everything people are buying, they all cost money. So I think the bottom line is it's just nice to know roughly what's happening. So I hope it's okay in Poland and everywhere else in the world. I hope everybody is staying safe, and I hope that we can get back to the jobs that we love as soon as possible. I was meant to be in May. I was meant to be going to Mexico. I was meant to be going back to the United States of America. I was meant to be going to Copenhagen. I was meant to be going to Qatar. So I've had to cancel all my work internationally. I teach mostly internationally at the moment as well. And obviously, like most people, I've had to cancel everything I was doing. Very frustrating, but at the same time, we obviously, the most important thing is life, it's not money. So we want to make sure that everybody's safe, that we all look after each other, and sooner or later we'll all get back to work. This is looking nice.
Okay.
What I'm just going to do first is just sort of talk you through the round side, which is where I'm going to start my my refining. I'm just going to go get another clip. When I refine, one of the things I would sometimes do is just clip the hair to a more natural fall position. And I would utilize this without any tension. So I would let the tension go. And I would then utilize this point here, the piece of hair there, as not going to be cut. We won't be cutting that. The second thing I would do is I would lightly mist the hair with some hairspray. See if I can't make this a little bit closer to you, for you guys. Okay. So, the first thing we're going to do is focus on refining from the front section, okay? When I refine, I use the very, very tip of my scissor, so I only use this part of my scissor. Now this is because it helps me to create a curved line, but it also helps me to take away very small amounts of hair at once. So as we go through here, so after a little bit I step back and I check my work and I can start to see that line is coming through okay. Now we've worked mostly underneath. Now when I push the hair back upright, we can see that there are some bits and pieces here that are not really helping the line to sit well. Now one way of doing it is to go through with your scissor like this, which helps you to take it away. The other way is to use a little pair of trimmers, which is all you do here is you lightly go over the hair. And that would be all you would do. And that'll just help you to flatten the line. Now, and now I start to create my line curving back. So again, I'm just going to stop and have a little check. So we'll move this back a tiny bit. Because once you're checking the detail, you then have to go through and check the form. So I'm going underneath my line. It's a real process. It takes some time to get this really right, in my opinion. And the next part I would do is I'd come to where the middle of the hairline is going to be. And I would start to just create myself a very slight guideline as to where this is going to come to. It's going to come to this section here. Okay. So now this is giving us a rough line. Now we can go through and start to remove the pieces underneath our line that are not helping us. And then we can go through and just very gently, it really just helps to flatten the line. I don't advise that you utilize that technique to form your line. I think you should be forming your line with your refining method, not the clipper. But the clipper or the trimmer or the razor, whatever it's called, it really does help to give you this lovely soft line. You can just see when I move it that there's something not quite right here. So we go back in. So far, so good. Okay. I want to just say, I've just took a glance at some of the wonderful comments people are saying. I honestly, sincerely, am very grateful that you're saying that. My section here looks a little bit heavy to me. I'm just going to re-lift that up. So the reason I did that, when I was working with my section, I just felt it looked a little bit stationary. So I went back through the haircut and just moved it very, very slightly to help me see where the bulk of the hair was. Okay, now from this point, we're going to work to here. Now, here we go, this is the fun part. This bit here is our guideline. That is what we know we need to get to. So what we do, see, this really helps to just make every little piece of hair sit down. Okay. What I'm going to do is just very, very slightly turn the camera around just so I can get the camera really close. So they're not working parallel, they're different shapes. So let's check that underneath. So you see underneath, it needs a little bit more work. Okay. Thank you, Anna. Okay, so now we let this drop a little bit. We turn it around. Now we can see the other points that we want to blend into. So then you want to groom down, because although it looks like it's finished, there will be some things that have just been tucked underneath instead of being cut. Let me just go over. Now, we remove the bulk of the hair first. And now we can go back in and get rid of all of the little bits of mess. Again, I advise that you visit the shop. When we finish this tutorial, the shop have got some amazing things. I'm gonna be buying, they sell an amazing ruler, and the ruler has head sheets on it, amazing. So cool. So you see, we don't use it for the line, the trimmer. We use it to flatten the line. And then I go back through and start to remove all these little bits out of the way. Now, let's see if I can't move this a little. Okay, so now you can see, if I was gonna go lower, which I'm just doing now, I've got a bit low, I'm sitting on a cutting stool. I can start to see underneath my line. So do move when you're cutting this. Don't just think it's done just because it looks good from one elevation. Move around. You've got to make sure that it looks good no matter how the client wears it. Okay, so we're starting to get there. As we move the hair around, we come back and check. And again, Very, very slight. I don't use them a huge amount, but they are very, very useful. Now, we need to finish this side. So the first thing I'm going to do Okay. Let's just turn it back around. Sorry about my breathing there. I think maybe my breathing was quite loud. I was holding my breath a lot when I was cutting, but I'm just gonna go over this a couple more times. Okay. I could do more. Are there any questions at all before I look to just wrap this up? Okay. So what I've done for you today is we blended a round graduation, which is a haircut that will come heavier towards here, like this, if you see. We cut this round graduation to blend into seamlessly. See that? To blend into a triangular graduation. So we did this by utilizing our vertical shape as triangle, and then it coexisted with our shape. As it came through, we've given ourselves a really nice shape that maybe is not that salon wearable, but it's something hopefully to keep strong hairdressers like yourself motivated through this terrible time. Okay, I just want to thank, before we sort of finish off really, I just want to thank everybody for your kind words. I absolutely am over the moon that Sebastian asked. I have a lot of respect for Sebastian, not just because his amazing mustache, but his incredible hair cutting. Huge thank you for being part of this today. Stay safe. And I hope to see you all again soon. Bye-bye.